فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
The third one, authentic, no problem. سالمة, safe from what? من ضعف الرواة والعلل. No defect, no weakness of the narrators. So there's five narration. All of them are different from the other. No, none of them resemble one another. Are you with me? At this point, what do we say? What do we say? This hadith has what? And it's different numbers. Are you all with me? Five, six narrations. The ulama, they said this one is also muhtaf bil qara'in. This hadith, even though it's mutawa, is ahad, but it is it benefits us knowledge which is certainty, just like the mutawatir. No, if it I said, if it has, if it's mashur, and it has different chains of narrations, and all of the chains of narration are safe from weakness and defect of the narrators. The third one, which is al-khabar al-musalsal bil aimat al-huffaz, the hadith which is narrated by the musalsal from the a'immat al-huffaz, the a'imma hifz have narrated it. Like who? Like Imam Ahmad narrates from Shafi'i, and Shafi'i narrates from Imam Malik. Like that hadith, the scholars say, even if it's one, it's ahad. Even if it's ahad, and Ahmad ibn Hanbal narrates from who? Shafi'i. And Shafi'i narrates from who? Imam Malik, rahimahullah. The scholars, they say, this hadith benefits what? It benefits us certainty, yaqeen. That's the third time. What is the wisdom? Where's the wisdom? What's the benefit does this do? What would it benefit us? Knowing that this benefits us this and this one benefits us this. It doesn't benefit us in terms of action. Pay attention. Any hadith which is ahad, will we implement it? Of course we will implement it. But if there comes a opposition, are you all with me? There comes a khilaf, ta'arub, opposition between a khabar, ahad, which is not al-muhtaf bil-qara'in, meaning those three, is not. It's a normal ahad. And one that is muhtaf bil-qara'in, they oppose each other. Which one would we give precedence to? Al-muhtaf bil-qara'in. So it is min awjuhu al-tarjih, from one of the ways to bring the evidences together. That's why the ulama want it. Are you with me? That's the importance of it. وَقَدْ يَقَعُ فِيهَا. And it may fall into it. مَا يُفِيدُ عِلْمُ النَّظَرِيِّ بِالْقَرَائِنِ عَلَى الْمُخْتَارِ. It will benefit. نعم. Then the Shaykh رحمه الله, he said, ثُمَّ الْغَرَابَةُ. The hadith which is غريب. إِمَّا يَكُونُ فِي أَصْلِ السَّنَدِ. It may happen in the beginning of the chain of narration. أو لا, or maybe not. فالأول, the first one, which is the one that happens in the في أصل السند, in the beginning of the chain, meaning from the angle of the Sahaba, is called الفرد المطلق, أما الغريب المطلق. We spoke about that yesterday, such as the hadith of Abdullah Ahmed, the hadith of Umar ibn al-Khattab, إنما الأعمال بالنيات. Or it may occur from the action, from where? والثاني, the second type, which is what? أن تكون الغرابة في أثناء السند, that the غريب that's happening in the hadith is happening whilst in the chain of narration. This one is called what? Al-Fardu Nisbi. And we gave the example of which hadith? We gave the example of Malik ibn Anas, narrating from Ibn Shihab al-Zuhri. Narrating from who? Ibn Shihab al-Zuhri, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he entered the city of Makkah, and on his head was what? A mighfar. The Prophet was wearing a helmet. We said that the person who singled this narration from Imam Ibn Shihab al-Zuhri, from all of the students he had, was who? Malik ibn Anas. So we said this hadith is fard nisbi, singular, due to Imam Malik being in the chain of narration. We spoke about that yesterday. So I'm referring to, you guys remember the hadith I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. I'm talking about the hadith of Anas ibn Malik, which is that the Prophet ﷺ entered وَعَلَى رَأْسِهِ الْمِغْفَرُ. So that's then the Shaykh rahimahullah, he said, وخبر الأحاد بنقل عدل تام الضبط متصل السند غير معلل ولا شاذ هو الصحيح لذاته. The Shaykh rahimahullah, he's now going into the point that I started at the beginning when I was talking, which is what? أقسام المقبول. The Sheikh here is now going into the types of maqbul, the accepted narrations, which is the first type that we're going to be speaking about from the two types, which was what? From the two types that were what? Al-maqbul al-mardud, the accepted narration and the rejected narration. The accepted narration, brothers, is two types. We've said it. It's the maqbul, the accepted one. We're going to look at it from two angles. The maqbul, we're going to look at it from two angles. The first one is aqsamul maqbul, the types of maqbul. And we said, how many types is that? We said that one is four. And then after that, inshallah, we're going to be talking about taqsimul maqbul ila ma'mulin bihi wa ghayra ma'mulin bihi. Dividing the maqbul in terms of implementing it and not implementing it. You're going to worry, well, how did that work? We'll see when we come to it. We're going to come to it later. But now we're going to take the types of maqbul. The types of maqbul. That's what we're going to do. How much are the types of maqbul? The Shaykh rahimahullah mentioned the first type, which is what? Sahihul lidati. The Shaykh defined sahihul lidati. What does sahihul lidati mean? What does the word sahih linguistically mean first? Let's explain that. Sahih, brothers, linguistically is the opposite to the word saqim, ill. وهو حقيقة في الأجسام مجاز في الحديث وسائر المعاني. It is a metaphor when it's used for hadith, but it's a reality, which is that it's literal when it's used for the body. The word sahih is originally literally used for the body. When it's used not for the body, it's a metaphor. To say that this hadith is sahih, it's a metaphor. It's not literal. That's not the way it should have. And remember, do you guys know what majaz means? Majaz means استعمال اللفظ في غير ما وضع له. Majaz in the Arabic language means to use a term or to use something in not how it was placed. You're using it in a way that it wasn't placed for. And inshallah we will come to that when we study her, when we come to Usul al-Fiqh. You see how the knowledge and the sciences are all connected? We'll come to it there, inshallah, which we're doing right now. That is what it means linguistically. What does it mean istilahan technically? Ibn Hajar rahimahullah defined it for you. What did he say? He said, مَتَّصَلَ سَنَدُوا بِنَقْلِ عَدْلٍ ضَابِطٍ عَنْ مِثْلِهِ إِلَى مُنْتَهَاهُ مِنْ غَيْرِ شُذُونٍ وَلَا عِلَّةٍ. It is when these characteristics are found. Are you all with me? These characteristics. And with that, Iraq, rahimahullah, what did he say? Iraq in his Alfiyah, he said, وَأَهْلُ هَذَا الشَّأْنِ قَسَمُ السُّنَنْ إِلَى صَحِيحٍ وَضَعِيفٍ وَحَسَنٍ. The scholars of this field, which is the science of hadith, they have divided the hadith into how many types? Sahih, Hasan, and Da'if. Sahih and Hasan are maqbul. Da'if is the mardood version. Pay attention, okay? And I mentioned why the da'if occurs. Two types, I mentioned it. A hadith that we want to say which is sahih. The sahih that's been spoken about here, brothers, is hadith which is sahih lidati. Meaning it is sahih in and within itself. Lidati, that's what it means. It is sahih in and within itself. It means that it has three things present and two things absent. A hadith which is sahih lidati. A hadith which is sahih lidati, meaning authentic in and within itself. It has three conditions present, and two conditions are missing. What are the conditions that are present and what are the conditions that are absent? The conditions that are present are as follows. Adalatu ruwat. The narrators are reliable. What does adl mean? What does adl mean? We have to explain each one. Adl means man lahu malaka tahmilu ala mulazamati taqwa wal muru'ah. Adl means anyone who has malaka, the ability, تحمله على ملازمة التقوى والمروءة. Two things have to be present in him. He has to be what? He has to have taqwa and he has to have adal revolves around these two, which is that he has taqwa and he has what? He has muru'a. He's upright, moral conduct. He has that. So that characteristics has to be what? Malaka. What does malaka mean? It's in him, without him having to look for it. Sifatul rasiqa is a characteristic that is embedded in him. That he has taqwa. Taqwa means, brothers, what? Fi'lul ma'muri wa chiyabul manhiyat. It's that he does everything Allah ordered him to do, and he stays away from everything that which Allah prohibited him from. The third one is what? He has al-muru'ah. He has what? Al-muru'ah. Which is, adabun nafsaniyya tahmilu mura'atuha ala at-tahalli bimahasin al-akhlaq wa jami'i al-aadat. He has good characteristics and manners. That's what he has. That individual has adala. That person, what does he have? He has adala. He is what? He is adl. The second characteristic that has to be present in a hadith, which we want to say is authentic, is tamamu dabtihim. The narrators who are narrating the hadith, they have dabt. Dabt is al-hafidhu yaqidhu. His memory is alert. غَيْرَ مُغَفَّلْ. He is not heedless. وَالشَّاكِ. And he is not also doubtful. When is he not? And when he, brothers, pay attention. His memory is alert. He is also not heedless. He is not in a state of doubt or assumption. From the time in which he took the narration to the time he passes the narration on. Pay attention. في حالتي التحمل والأداء. The time he took the narration, he has to have that hafidha present. And the time he's passing it on, he has to also have it. And the dabt is two types, brothers. Dabtu sadrin. The first one is the memory of the chest. He's actually memorized it from the heart. وهو الذي يثبت ما سمعه بحيث يتمكن من استحضاره متى شاء. And that means the dabt for dabtu sadr means he can bring it out. It's present in him. And he can extract it. He can bring it out whenever he needs it. He doesn't go, no. He needs the narration, he brings the chain of narration straight away. Ah. That is dabtu sadrin. The second one is what? Dabtu kitabin. This man's memory or his dabt is based in a book. It's in the book. It's placed inside a book. That book, brothers, has to have these conditions. Sawnatu an turuq. الخلل إليه من حين سمع فيه وقابله إلى أن يؤدي منه. That book has to be safe from any distortion and any tampering of anyone from the time in which he heard this hadith. هيا. From the time in which he perfects his book until the time he conveys the narration from that book. His book has to be in a safe, protected place. Those are what? Those are the first two. The third one is اتصال السند. The chain of narration has to be connected. What does that mean? It means بأن يكون كل راو من رواتي, that every narrator in that chain قد تحمله, he had taken it from ممن فوقه, from the one above him. He took it from him. بطريق معتبر من طرق التحمل, from one of the ways which are taken into consideration, such as حدثنا أخبرنا أنبأنا and etc. Are you with me? Good. Those three have to be present. Are you with me? His memory has to be good. Complete memory. So the first one is fully reliable. He also has to be what? Complete memory. Third, chain of narration has to be connected. Chain of narration has to be connected with those three conditions. And the absence of the two that I'm going to mention now, the hadith becomes sahih lidati. What are the two that have to be my option? Intifa'ul illah. A defect has to be absent from the hadith. The hadith should not have any defect. The defect here, brothers, has to be very well understood. The illah, which is considered that we're referring to here, has to be khafi, hidden. Ghamid, very hidden. يَقْدَحُ فِي صِحَّةِ الْحَدِيثِ, that harms the authenticity of the hadith. From the apparent, الَّذِي ظَاهِرُهَا, from the الَّذِي ظَاهِرُهُ السَّلَامَةَ مِنْهَا. But from the apparent, the hadith looks clean. Nothing's wrong with it, from the outside. And don't worry, brothers. The illah is going to come to us in a very, very, very extensive way. Don't worry. But pay attention. The defect has to be khafi. It has to be what? غامض. It has to be hidden. Pay attention. That has to be absent. There should not be no defect. ولذلك الشيخ, the great Imam, حقيقة, he was an Imam. Sheikh Muqbil ibn Hadi al-Wadi'i, rahimahullah, rahmatan wasi'ah. He wrote a book called He wrote a book in which he called it Ahadithun Mu'alla. ظاهرها الصحة. Something like that. Ahadith which are defected. They've got defect. From the apparent, they look what? Look sahih. Oh. The Shaykh was very good with that. رحمه الله تعالى. The second thing that has to be absent is what? Shudud. Shudud means what? Shudud, amashad, means ما خالف فيه الثقة من هو أوثق منه. It is an opposition of a person who is reliable, who is also good memory, but he opposes a person who has greater reliability than him and who has greater memory than him. He opposes them. And don't worry, that is also going to come to us in what? In details. The illah and the shudud will come to us in details. All of them are going to come to us in details. Ittisal of sanad is going to come to us in details. Huh? Sheikh is going to go in details. So we're going to take it as it comes. So that we just mentioned is the definition and the explanation for sahihul lidati. The hadith which is sahihul lidati. ولذلك Iraqi said, رحمه الله in his ألفية فالأول المتصل الإسناد بنقل عدل ضابط الفؤاد عن مثله من غير ما شذوذ وعلة قادحة فتودي, which is the point that we mentioned. Ibn Hajar goes on to saying, he goes on to saying, وتتفاوت رتبه بتفاوت هذه الأوصاف. The levels of the hadith which is sahih, its levels differ. They're not all the same. In terms of strength, in terms of those characteristics that we mentioned, they differ. Even in the matter of ittisal, the connection of the chain of narration, they're not all the same. This one's connected, and this one's connected, but the connection of this chain of narration and the connection of this chain of narration are not the same. Huh? They differ. Huh? التي تنبني صحة عليها. They differ. And they differ. So what is he trying to hint here? He is trying to hint that there are chains of narration. Even that the other chains of narrations are what? Even that the other chains of narrations are authentic. But scholars, they said that the chain of narration which are the most authentic, they chose names. Even that other chains may be authentic, but these ones are very, very strong. And an example of it is what we just took previously, that if Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal narrated from Shafi'i and Shafi'i narrated from Malik, then that hadith is very strong. We just said it's called Musalsal bi al-A'immat al-Hufaz. Very, very strong. But scholars have argued, everyone mentioned that he believes that this hadith is the highest in terms of chains. Zuhri, مثلا, if he narrates from Salim ibn Abdullah, Zuhri narrates from Salim, and Salim narrates from his father, Abdullah ibn Umar. This hadith, some scholars, they said, is very powerful. Some said, no, Hamad ibn Salama narrates from Thabit, and Thabit narrates from Anas ibn Malik. This is one of the most, some scholars said this. Some said, no, Suhail ibn Abi Salih narrates from his father, Abi Salih, and Abi Salih ibn Abdul Rahman. Then narrates from Abu Hurairah. Some said, this is the most authentic chain of narration. All of these, Iraqi rahimahullah, he said, إمساكنا على الحكم بأنه أصح مطلقا وقد خاض به قوم فقيل مالك عن نافع بما روى عنه الناس. Some scholars have chosen to say that this hadith is the most authentic chain of narration, and some say this is the most authentic chain of narration, and some said no, this is the most authentic chain of narration. Iraqi said إمساكنا, we withhold from this. Iraqi in his ألفية, to really say that this hadith is the most authentic chain of narration, he said it's not befitting. But what's the wisdom behind it? Why would the scholar say that this chain of narration is the most authentic chain of narration? Again, it is when there comes a chain which is the most authentic chain and a normal chain which is what? Authentic, but is not as strong as this one, because this is from the what? From the Asahul Asanid. They give precedence to this. That's why, عند العمل, عند التعارض, when there comes opposition, then Asahul Asanid are unique. The greater. نعم.